In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Paula has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with Paula. Together may we meet Christ Jesus, when he who is our life appears in glory. Our true home is heaven, and Jesus Christ, whose return we long for, will come from heaven to save us. Because God has chosen to call Paula from this life to himself, we commit her body to be cremated, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend Paula to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise her up on the last day. And let us turn to Christ Jesus with confidence and faith in the power of his cross and resurrection. And a response after each prayer is, Lord of mercy. Risen Lord, pattern of our life forever, Lord of mercy. Promise and image of what we shall be, Lord of mercy. Son of God, who came to destroy sin and death, Lord of mercy. Word of God, who delivered us from the fear of death, Lord of mercy. Crucified Lord, forsaken in death, raised in glory, Lord of mercy. Lord Jesus, you bless those who mourn and are in pain. Bless Lil and all Paula's family and friends who gather around her today, Lord have mercy. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, we pray together the Lord's Prayer for Paula as we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Now I'd ask Fergal to come up to do a reflection for us to share.
Lillian asked me to say something regarding what was a big part of Paula's life, and that was her work at Dublin Airport, serving in the airport search unit. Paula was one of the originals. She started her career in the very first ASU class back in 2001, gradually progressing up the ranks to supervisor. So she has deep roots and made many friends working at the airport. Indeed, she found many old friends from previous jobs working in the ASU. Paula was what you would describe as a professional. Her career was characterized by a strong work ethic and attention to detail, dedication, commitment, and as a supervisor, an excellent organizer and leader. She didn't shy away from challenges. Her sense of commitment to work, her friends, colleagues, job, and team was selfless. Her enthusiasm and passion for the role led her to meet and work with many others from across the security team and DAA organization. She had incredible drive, and whether as a team member or leading a team, she sought to accomplish her duties to the highest of standards. You had to earn Paula's respect. Your word mattered little if it wasn't backed by deed. When we were faced with challenges, Paula always found the energy to step up to the plate and put her shoulder to the wheel. She led from the front and had a keen understanding and insight of the operation to move people and goods safely and securely through the airport. She had a passion for the work and the team that she was such a big part of. A good example of Paula's commitment was an important project vital to the security and commercial success of Dublin Airport. The work conducted on this project received high praise from EU inspectors, who described the project as gold standard. Paula was proud of what she had accomplished along with her teammates, but she was not one for bragging. She knew she was part of a team. You were only as good as your weakest link. So she did not rest. She was constantly striving and thinking of ways to improve. Paula sensed things that others could not. such as a 3 o'clock slump he experienced during a long 12-hour shift. She knew how a simple action and gesture such as buying sweets helped to relieve the slump, boost morale and lighten the mood. It also revealed a kindness and affection towards her colleagues. It was a gesture simple but revealing of her character. According to Lillian, she carried this tradition on during her treatment, bringing the same fizzy sweets to nurses' stations to help them get through the day and night. I was second in the second ASU class that came after Paula's intake. I remember working alongside her in Basement South before a promotion. Basement South was a post I enjoyed because it took you away from the madness above. It was quiet and relaxed. It was also a great place to get to know people that you worked alongside. It was the first time we really talked. She was so candid and warm. She talked about her life, her hopes, her family, her mom and dad, her love of football, playing football, and her passion for Liverpool Football Club. She loved her family and spoke with such warmth about her brothers and sisters, her nieces and nephews. She loved and cherished her mother and father. You gain an insight into others at times like that. It was really my first time talking to a woman who was a lesbian. And Paula's story and raw experiences helped to inform me and make me challenge some of my prejudices, preconceptions and opinions. She had a gift of being able to explain difficult things and the courage to know who she was and to be proud of who she was. I was struck by her courage, passion and wisdom. Some of the many things I came to admire about Paula, her pride in who she was and where she came from, that the values imparted by her parents shaped her and gave her the strength to stand tall. She had grit and determination, she was honest and wanted the best for herself and for others. I had the good fortune to start with Paula together as supervisors in 2008. She shined in this role, she worked hard and set an example of leadership for others. Even if she appeared to be a bit of a rough diamond, she had integrity. She was direct but honest. She didn't suffer fools but wasn't blind to others' suffering. As I said, Paula could sense things in others. Beyond the tough exterior, she had a big heart, and for those that needed a comforting hand, an ear that listened, a shoulder to cry on, or some sound advice and direction, she was there. Paula encouraged others to meet challenges head on, to have strength, to be proud and believe in yourself. She gave people hope and encouragement and confidence to meet whatever challenge they had to confront. Where she saw potential, she nurtured it. She always wanted to help, but most importantly, she knew how to help. Paula didn't advertise what she did for others. She understood and valued the importance of discretion. She was a rock for many when they needed it. She valued others, and if someone was hurting, she was hurting. If you had Paula as a friend, you had a true friend. Lillian, yourself and Paula have made a lovely couple. I really do think you and she blossomed over the years. You both seem so happy and at ease with each other, the best of friends. You certainly were the love of her life, and she loved every moment spent with you. Paula enriched the lives of those she met, and she stood up for those who couldn't stand up for themselves. She was a great woman, and I can say with full certainty that I speak for each and every one of my colleagues that we were so very proud and privileged to have worked alongside Paula. So farewell, Paula. We will miss you dearly. Your duty is done. Bon voyage, and when you get there, rest easy.
Thanks, Fergal, for those lovely, touching few words. So God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of Paula, for in her heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. So we just pray one Hail Mary, just asking our Blessed Lady to watch over all of us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And we pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son Jesus was dying, help all those who mourn for Paula and accompany all of us in our time of need. Eternal rest grant unto Paula, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. And may Paula's soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. And during our final song, Paula's coffin will move in behind the curtain.